Isso aí. Tocar um som. Estamos começando a nossa live. E eu quero saber de vocês se a gente está ao vivo. Galera aí do chat, me ajuda. Me diz se a gente está ao vivo mesmo. Quem está falando aqui, senhoras e senhores, é Milton Menezes. Eu fiz a barba, mas ainda sou eu mesmo. Ah, eu estou vendo aqui que sim, estamos ao vivo. E eu peço, inclusive, para vocês que estão assistindo a gente do Facebook e do YouTube, que compartilhem essa live, né? Curtam a live, façam a subscription no canal, porque assim a gente consegue aumentar essa comunidade de arte digital, que nem a gente está fazendo hoje pela Unhide, com a Hide School, com a Hide Group, que é esse nosso movimento de ensinar a galera, educar a galera, conectar os artistas com as empresas, conectar os artistas com eles mesmos, né? Com as produtoras, com os clientes que você quer trabalhar, ou com a empresa que você quer trabalhar junto ou ser contratado, né? Eu tô enrolando aqui, justamente, ó, o pessoal tá chegando aí, Caio Nascimento, o Murilo, Alisson, Linha Lima, fala galera, beleza? Rafael Braz, tá sim. O Leandro, opa, na expectativa, meu querido. Thiago Scaff do YouTube, galera do YouTube e do Facebook, olha que legal. Agora a gente consegue fazer live nos dois canais. Eu vou compartilhar aqui agora. Estamos ao vivo. Imagina a dificuldade de compartilhar, escrever e continuar falando algo que seja medianamente interessante. Estamos ao vivo. Postei. Foi. Estou livre disso. Bem-vindo vocês, que hoje é uma live especial, galera. Hoje a gente tem uma live que é muito maneira. Ah, o que a gente vai falar aqui hoje é extremamente relevante para quem trabalha com Photoshop e com 3D. E especialmente para quem trabalha com essas duas coisas juntas, né? Para essa galera que não se contenta com render e vai para o Photoshop trabalhar a sua imagem, até porque um render sem tratamento é igual uma foto em RAW, né? Aquela foto crua que, por mais bonita que esteja, não tem como. O Photoshop, ele sempre soma, né? Eu sinto que quando o Photoshop não soma é porque você não fez direito. E o 3D se beneficia muito de um bom Photoshop. Eu costumo brincar que um Photoshop mediano vira, oh, um Photoshop, um 3D, um render mediano com Photoshop fica melhor do que um render bem feito e um Photoshop mal feito que não vai ressaltar as qualidades desse render. Ah, o Alan Kennedy está acabando de dizer aquilo pelo Facebook, que está acompanhando essa live diretamente do Acre, a terra dos dinossauros e dos mapinguaris, que eu não faço ideia o que é, mas deve ser algum tipo de descendente de dinossauro, alguma tribo, e possivelmente eu estou cometendo alguma gafe e nem sei disso. Ah, galera falando que a música está mais alta do que minha voz. E agora? Melhorou? Espero que sim. Espero que sim. Obrigado pelo feedback. Galera sempre ajudando a gente aí a fazer essa live cada vez melhor. Pronto, ó. Bem baixinho agora. E eu queria dizer o seguinte: hoje, para quem não sabe, essa live vai ser com um russo, né? Estamos conectando aí Brasil com Rússia, com esse cara que é mais brasileiro do que russo. E eu queria mostrar um pouquinho do que a gente vai falar hoje. Então, deixa eu entrar aqui agora aqui no meu desktop. Pronto, bem-vindos ao meu desktop. E aqui a gente está na página da Unhide School. E justamente hoje o que a gente vai estar falando é sobre um projeto novo que a gente tem na Unhide School, que é muito especial e que inclusive acabou de sair, que se chama CGI Car Visualization. O CGI Car Visualization é o novo curso da Unhide School de carro, que na boa. Vamos combinar. Quem sabe fazer carro bem feito não ensina como é que faz carro bem feito, porque essa pessoa está faturando muitos dinheiros e não está compartilhando isso, ou ela simplesmente não tem tempo de compartilhar porque ela está faturando muitos dinheiros fazendo carro. Carro é ainda um mercado extremamente relevante, né? Tem quantos carros aí? Você faz carro para indústria automotiva, você faz carro para distribuidoras, né, concessionárias. Você faz carro às vezes numa cena que não é nem de carro ou tem carro nela, enfim. É, carro definitivamente, saber fazer um carro bem feito é mais ou menos igual fazer um packshot bem feito. A sua voz baixou bastante agora. Tá baixa ainda, gente? Aqui para mim parece que tá alto. Fala aí para mim se tá baixo ou se tá bom. Deixa eu testar aqui no meu. Deixa eu ver.
De carro ou tem
Parece
carro.
que tá bom, gente. Aumenta aí o som porque parece que tá bom. Me confirma aí, mas eu acho que tá bom. E eu queria falar agora desse curso aqui de carro que eu tava falando é o seguinte: carro é packshot, é um produto. Então saber fazer um carro não é necessariamente, ah, vou trabalhar só para indústria automotiva. Não. Você saber iluminar bem um objeto, saber inserir um objeto 3D na cena bem feito. Se você sabe fazer isso com um carro, que é extremamente difícil, porque o carro ele tem a superfície completamente reflexiva, então se você consegue fazer isso bem feito em 3D e bem photoshopado, vamos falar assim, bem apresentado, né? Cara, você sabe fazer qualquer produto. Porque saber colocar um produto com uma luz bonita, ainda por cima colocar em cenários de outdoor, né? De locação, seja 3D, ou seja compado, ou seja misturado locação com 3D, você saber fazer isso é uma skill muito valiosa. Poucas pessoas sabem. Eu sinto que a galera da Alemanha, né, é muito precursora disso, Recon e outras empresas, mas a gente já vai falar disso. Antes eu quero introduzir isso daqui. Isso daqui que nada mais é do que o nosso novo curso de carro com esse nosso amigo russo maravilhoso chamado Dimitri. E antes de mais nada, eu queria dar um play nessa introdução aqui, ó.
Hello everyone, welcome to my tutorial about car visualization in advertising industry. In this tutorial, we will learn the full pipeline of car production in advertising industry. My name is Dmitry, I'm from Russia, and I will help to get all this knowledge in our tutorial. So, we will learn all the information by these images about Aston Martin Vantage, what is really new car. So we have here a beautiful set with back view, rear view, side view, some little crops. We will work with big high-res resolution. So another rear view. So lots of good images for one set. But and actually, this one is the one scene, just the different cameras positions. And we will play with this. We will learn how to find the best camera angle for the very sexy, nice shot. And we are going to do it step by step, one by one. At the beginning, we will get some basic knowledge about how to get the idea, how to create the concept, because that's a very important part. So, because lots of questions about, hey, what's the best idea, or I'm out of ideas, how can I get this? So, and we will try to find the solution, because ideas,
Chega,
in
chega,
general,
chega,
they are
parou,
around
parou.
us.
Silêncio, Dima, porque se você quer saber mais, entra no site da High School, até porque esse vídeo tem 9 minutos e a gente só tem uma hora de live. E o que eu quero mostrar para vocês, antes de mais nada, é isso daqui, ó. É a quantidade de projetos e conhecimento que o Dima colocou nesses cursos. Tanto da parte de pré-produção, pós-produção, de conceito, introdução e a parte de 3D. E tudo isso vai começar a cair aqui. E a gente acabou de lançar esse curso. Então, para chamar aqui, para me ajudar a apresentar isso daqui, eu chamei o meu amigo Dima. Fala, Dima.
Fala, Milton. Fala,
Tudo bem?
galera. Tudo bem?
Fala, galera. Gasta o seu português aí, Dima.
Sorry?
Speak in português.
Fala, galera. Tudo bem?
One minute, Dima.
Yeah.
Galera, eu vou trocar essa live pra inglês, porque senão o nosso entrevistado não vai entender nada. Mas já deu pra ver que ele arranha um pouquinho de português. Isn't it right, Dima? You speak a little bit of Portuguese.
Yes, and you ask me don't use these words in Portuguese, what I know. Actually, these words helps me a lot to live in Brazil, because I can explain almost everything what I need, but these words, they're quite rude, but you learned me these words. So, anyway.
Welcome, Dima, to this Unhigh Live. It's been a while since we don't chat, isn't it right?
Yes, almost like 2 months, 1.5. And, you know, this 2 days ago, here in Moscow was a big conference, CGI conference, and I've got a little bit deja vu because it was Holiday Inn, it was cold weather, there was Beeple, Jama, Konrad Allen, and, you know, and Holiday Inn and CGI conference. And if don't look outside, and, you know, because there are no palm trees outside, so, and yeah, for a little bit, we could try to imagine like we're still in São Paulo at Unhigh conference, and yeah.
This is so cool, man, because we have lots of new people, and the community is growing so fast. And
I saw it.
Right now, we have this guy here saying Johnny Costa. Johnny is saying he's starting today in this Unhigh world, and it's cool because.
Nice.
It's not only the school, right? It's the conference. So we have this all year teaching it and bringing new stuff and stuff from the market and the things we do in the daily basis to make money. Isn't it true?
Yeah, that's definitely true.
And tell me, Dima, where are you, man?
Right now, I see it in Russia. So, and yeah, I spent some part of my time and another part I spent in German in Stuttgart. I'm kind of like between of my relocating there. But definitely, man, he is here and in German, there are much colder than in Brazil right now, I guess. And I miss Brazil. Yeah, I miss palm trees, ocean. And our chats and all the community, because I told lots of times you have such a great community in Brazil, like very friendly, very useful and powerful. So that's very cool. And I really like to be there. And, you know, sometimes I feel, but not sometimes, all the time I feel like I'm more a part of Brazilian community than Russian or some others.
You are the most Brazilian Russian that I know. Well, I don't know many Russians anyways, but...
I know one more Argentinian guy, but he has been living in Russia more than 10 years.
Hello, everyone.
I know one more guy. He's Brazilian, but with a little bit Russian experience. This is Felipe Beckman, because his wife is Russian, right? And he used to live in Moscow also. So, and this is, at least you have two teachers in Unhigh, like one Russian with Brazilian experience and one Brazilian with Russian experience.
That's
See
true.
How close we are.
So, did you have connections with Felipe Beckman back in the day?
First time we've met at Unhigh conference. We've never met before. Yeah, we're new to each other, so like online, but in real life we've met first time at this Unhigh conference in São Paulo, and yeah, we have a chat time by time. And yeah, that's cool.
And let me tell you something. I'm watching your tutorials and I'm thinking, like, what's it all about? Tell me a little bit. I'm watching right now for the first time. Because I think we just released, right?
Right.
It's new for me as well, and I see a lot of Photoshop as well as CGI stuff. Tell us a little bit of the process. What are you gonna be showing us? Because I'm super curious.
Okay. Last time, like maybe 1.5 year, I spent I was working a lot with German market and as a result with cars industry. So because German has very nice, powerful cars and very beautiful. I can say the same about Russian cars or sorry, Brazilians also, but German does. And
everything came from Germany, right? About like, all the car design Japan as well.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. I guess like Japan, German and UK and a little bit US. Yeah. Definitely not Brazil and Russian market.
No. Brazil's just bananas and samba and football and creatives.
That's
CGI.
That's also. Yeah. That's also very. Yeah. Okay. At least you have much better thing. We have just snow and vodka and at least something. Okay.
We have cachaça. It's kind of. Well, we like vodka better.
Yeah, that's good to know that. Okay. So, what happened? Why I relocated? I'm relocating to German because I have a few friends and we were working a lot, I don't know, like past years. And this year, we kind of like... We decided that okay, we need to go to the next step, and we created a small team. One of our partner, David, he has been working in Daimler, what is Mercedes, more than 10 years. And as a result, this is how we started to work directly with Daimler, and we've got connections with the other brands, and this is how we've got lots of projects for big brands and. We did lots of projects, but I guess at the beginning I started to get my knowledge about car visualization when I was working in the Reconfirm house, and I guess these guys gave me lots of knowledge about how to set the whole process, because I'm definitely not the guy who really want to create one image by one render, like one. I know this kind of artist. They spend lots of hours for create one best render. You know, for me it's again all the time. It's the question of quality and time. And for me, pipeline is much easier if I can prepare everything what I need in 3D and then jump to Photoshop, because I started as a retoucher. 2D artist, and then I started to integrate more and more 3D to my pipeline. And this is what I use. And in this course about this car visualization, I try to show like my way, my pipeline, where I really like to use Photoshop and 3D. And as a result, I showed at the beginning, yeah, for sure, we need some concept. And I don't have specific education. I'm kind of like bad doctor. I didn't finish my university, but it was in my life. But definitely I don't have some drawing skills, but I really like to create some sketches because I like to visualize my ideas. And this is what I showed also at the beginning of this course, how we can get some ideas, because again, I grow, I think I raced in Brazilian market, and Brazilian market, if you look at the your layouts, it's like a trend. Brazilian market, Brazilian layouts, they are always, you know, colorful, bright, sometimes crazy. And, you know, I think you know why Brazilian art directors has such a nice, crazy ideas. It's illegal in Russia, but in Brazil, you have lots of funny helpers, call it like that. This is why I like to use some very interesting creative ideas. And this is what I tried to show, how we can get the ideas, because sometimes people can model a car or take a car from the stock. And again, I showed the people how they can get a model for free, because there are some sources nowadays. You don't need to model a car. I think you will be agree with me that usually clients don't have enough time and budgets to model a car from scratch. It doesn't make sense. Yes, definitely.
Modeling a car takes too long. And once you do it, once you have the CAD, because you need it to print the car anyways, It doesn't yes. make any sense yes. to do it all over again, spend more money. And some brands, yes. they don't like to give the CAD data, and it doesn't make sense to me. But most of the biggest ones, they do.
Yeah, they do. But even if they don't have, you can buy a model on TurboSquid or on another stocks. It will be cost like a few hundred bucks. But in our tutorial, I showed people how and where they can get even a CAD data model for free, because some of guys modeled them for fun and just shared them for free. And okay, we've got the model. And the next question, you know, about the concept. And I showed the people how they can get the idea, create a mood board and create some sketch. You know, I like to create some sketches using a mouse. Even if I have a vacant tablet, I like to draw by mouse because it can help me to visualize by like using very rough shapes just to bring my idea. And then when we have a concept, when we have a main hero, like 3D, like geometry of a car, I talked and showed a little bit about modeling, but I didn't make a big accent on this. It was more about how to use some basics to model some simple concrete environment. And then we were talking about some creating textures for Team, environment and
I,
then
can
put
I ask
a
you car- something?
Yeah.
I have the project right here in front of me. And
hello.
And I have all the videos and everything. And I would like to ask you a little bit about the stages, just like you're telling me now, but I'm going to show it on the screen. So the first one, you talk about pre-production, production, and post-production. What is it all about?
Yes, in this part, I was talking a little bit about pipeline, because we are not teaching people just to creating some images for fun. Yes, I guess there are some people like that who just want to create for themselves. But you and me, we are like current unit of this market. And I try to explain people how it works. What's the difference between pre-production, production, and post-production? Because there are like three main steps. What you can apply for every project, and it doesn't matter is it still image, video, or everything. So, and I kind of like try to give people some knowledge about how market works, and how the project works, something like that.
And you also, the next one, you give a general sense about 3ds Max, because you're using 3ds Max in this project, isn't it right?
Yes, in this project, yes. So, yeah, I still use 3ds Max and I like it. Yes, in my projects, like nowadays, I use Cinema 4D more and more, but still 3ds Max is like first love. And yes, I try to show this because, again, Cinema 4D is very good for especially for motion, but for still images, 3ds Max is sometimes it's faster, and it's just my current workflow. And yes, I gave them just some basics about environment and how it works. I didn't show like how every buttons works, but my goal was give the people again the general knowledge what they will be able to apply to any other software. So I didn't teach them which exact button they
Welcome
need to
the
push. I tried
class.
To. I tried to explain them how it works in general. It means like if they get this knowledge, they will be able to apply it for Cinema 4D, Maya, or Blender, or any other things. This was my goal.
That's cool. At the moment, I'm showing some 3ds Max classes, basic setups in 3ds Max. I think it's one of your first classes. And then I saw you using V-Ray.
Yes, V-Ray. I really like this software. A few times I tried to switch to another render engines, and but still I came back to V-Ray. Especially nowadays, V-Ray works really, really well because, you know, some of engines, they are CPU or GPU, and you need to make a choice. V-Ray, yes, sometimes it doesn't work super perfect, but in general, I think it's just a question of time. But you can use CPU and GPU at the same time. You don't need to make a choice, and I think this is very great because I don't want to make the choice between CPU, GPU. I want to use like all the sources of my workstation. It's just reasonable. So, and yeah, and Ferrell is very useful. So,
yeah, I think it's really cool to have the choice, right? If you want to use GPU or CPU. And I think V-Ray is a great choice for that because you have the option to go both, right?
And yes, you can go the both, and also you can use and CPU and GPU at the same time.
This is really cool. I don't think the other softwares, Octane or Redshift,
no.
You can do that.
Octane,
it's just graphic card. Just GPU.
Octane is just graphic card. Redshift is good, but in Redshift you have to make a choice between CPU or GPU. It can work the both way, but it can blend together and use together. But V-Ray, it can use at the same time CPU and GPU.
This is really cool. I think most of the 3D softwares used out there is 3ds Max and V-Ray is definitely the most popular render engine, isn't it?
Yeah. And yeah, I used V-Ray for a long time and I really like it. But again, you know, this one is very often questioned about which software do you prefer. And for me, it's like a tool, you know, and you can create the same image using the different software, because software is just the taste. It's like, I really like to make association about like the girls. Which girls do you prefer? Like black, blonde, I don't know, red. Again, it's up to taste. You know, there are no correct or wrong answer. It's also just a taste. The same with software, with render engine or with 3D software. And again, even when I showed V-Ray in this class, also I tried to explain the basics, what people will be able to use. People will be able to use this knowledge also for Octane, for Corona, or for any other render.
I have Bodan. I think Bodan is saying only cycles beside V-Ray can use GPU and CPU at the same time. This is cool. Yeah, that's true. Cycles from Blender.
Okay.
Yeah, you can use GPU and CPU as well. But other than that, just V-Ray. And I think it's cool because I think so far at Un High School, we only have been teaching Octane and I don't think we use Redshift, but we definitely use Cycles with the Neuromancer stuff.
We used Redshift at your project for Micro Epic, when we created lots of. Do you remember this project?
Which one?
Micro Epic.
Oh,
like the human cell.
Yeah. It's on the website. Let me show.
Yes, in this project we used Redshift because all the other render agents, they said fuck off because they couldn't work with so much polygons there, because there were like over than 70 million polygons with lots of SSS and V-Ray, Octane, and the other render agents, they just didn't work at all. Redshift, only one render engine. What could handle this job?
Yeah, I'm showing right now. It's pretty cool. So, Demon not only works specialty with cars, he's a car specialist, but also Demon can do everything. It's like one-man army, really. Demon. And
yes.
I also see at Un High School that you have the concept stage. So you show concepting stuff as well. Do you do that on a daily basis? How do you do that?
Yes, I showed because I really like to do this. And as I said earlier, I like to draw it using my mouse because sometimes people don't like, or sometimes they are afraid to creating concepts because they feel like, okay, I have no idea how to draw correct, or it looks like shit and something like that. And I just try to explain them that who cares? It's just for you. You need to try, you know, bring your idea, visualize your idea, and you can use even mouse for this. You don't need to have a vacuum or something like that. You can use the mouse and just use a lasso tool and just roughly block the main shapes just to get the main composition and feeling. And I showed how to create the mood board because that's only important thing for every project, not about cars. Creating the mood board, create some references. I'm not telling about copying, but it's very important to bring some references about the mood, you know. And yeah, I try to show this. Like, okay, because I wanted to create at the beginning of this project, I've got one idea. Like, okay, I had a car, and I wanted to create some kind of like after moon, after rain mood, and like sunset is touching a little bit car and something like that. And I just started to bring some references like this after rain mood, you know, when lots of clouds and just sun is coming through the like small gap between clouds and touching the car. And yeah, and I try to find these references because with no references, it's very difficult. You have in your mind some kind of like imagination about how it should work, but when you try to create the real image, it's very important to have some references near the hand because it helps a lot. You can see how it works in real life and just try to repeat and try to simulate.
And you also talk about composition. So it's not only cars, it's about everything, right? It's about concepting the image, the composition of the elements, rendering.
Yes.
It's a whole package.
Yes, it's a whole package. Exactly.
It's cool. This is pretty cool, man. Like, I think most of the people in Brazil, this was always a mystery. How do you do realistic cars? How do you retouch cars? And we never had any course before in Brazil about that. And of course, you have other courses. There's Eastern Chang, lots of nice photographers teaching how to retouch cars. But I never seen a CGI car / retouch class in one package. Never seen anything like that. And this is like completely like unhigh kind of situation because people are just giving away, this is how I do it.
Yes, and I get lots of messages to Instagram or Behance about, hey, do you have some tutorials about the car visualization? And now I can say, yes, I do. Go there. So
finally. English with subtitles, because if people, you know, most of our viewers are in Brazil, but we have subtitles in all classes. If we don't have in the beginning, we're gonna have soon, because
hello everyone, we finished our big part of our course, more theory.
And we try to have subtitles as fast as we can, but sometimes we rather post what we have and subtitle on the way. So we have fresh stuff all the time. Every month we have a new course. That's our goal.
That's cool.
It's cool, man. I think this course, I want to take it. I want to watch it. Dima?
I thought you already did.
Oh, this one? No, I didn't have the time. We just finished editing and we published today. How would I have seen it? I want to watch it like now, like there is everything out there with subtitles as well.
Okay, come on. Okay, my English is so bad that you prefer to watch it with subtitles.
It's good to have sometimes. Let's say from get something, it's down there.
Okay.
Do you watch tutorials in other languages or just English? Or do you watch tutorials in general?
Yes, definitely I do. So, and I guess I watch tutorials on two languages, English and Russian, because I don't know any other languages. My German is even worse than Portuguese, so.
Okay, and now I'm showing the videos of, you know, the models, how you get your models.
Hello everyone, welcome back to our...
So, you mentioned that you use TurboSquid. I think everybody does, right? Who doesn't?
Yes, there are lots of any other sources. So, and yeah, for sure, I showed the people how they can get and where we usually get the models. It's like CG Trader, TurboSquid, Humfrey-D, and other stuff like that. But also, I tried to show the people some any other sources where, because if they're beginners, they don't want to spend even like few hundred bucks for the model, just for learning. And I show them some links where they can get some models for free, some good models for free. It's legal ways, because I know like in Russia, in Brazil, people sometimes know how to use the other links, not on the official, but yeah.
I have a question.
Okay.
I know you work with stock and you know, TurboSquid, whatever stock you have available, but I know that sometimes, most of the times, you have CAD data. You have the actual CAD model from the brand, whatever brand, could be Audi, could be Tesla, whatever. And what's the best? I mean, what's the difference between modeling or not modeling? Sorry, getting something from TurboSquid. You know, it's easy, cheap. To getting something like a CAD data. What's the difference of working with different files?
The difference is about quality, because CAD data, it has almost everything what you need. Sometimes we've got model where it was all the engine, like details under the bonnet, all the transmission things, and at this moment we realized like, okay, now we've got troubles, because like it was almost impossible to turn the model in viewport because it was super heavy. You know, try to imagine like every screw like under the bonnet and every, I don't know, some small dots, like everything, even cylinders in engine, everything. So, and in this case, we had to remove all these parts because actually when you need to render like just the outdoors, just exterior, you don't need all these details. So, and in general, for exteriors, usually models from TurboSquid and CG Trader, that's more than enough, because there are not so much details. If we talk about interiors, it's very difficult to find very detailed interiors on stocks. So it's more tricky, and this is when it's very important to have CD data. And also the same thing, if sometimes we need to create some images, you know, where we need to show the transmission, like the wheels, transmission, some part of engine. And in this case also we need a CD date model, because it's impossible to find on TurboSquid some details like that. But for most of exterior images, it's just some polygonal low poly models that's enough for creating.
And it makes sense, right? Especially if you're not, if you're working on a personal project, or if you're working on something that the car is not the main thing, it's just, you know, a street with cars passing by. Either way, I think it's a great tool to have access to all these car library with Turbo Squid and all the others. But it's definitely great to have the cat, right? Because you have the perfect car. There's nothing wrong about it. It's
the same model that went
to, I don't know, the printing process, the industry.
Yep, that's definitely true, but it's not possible.
Ass, right? And to clean all that CAD data, 2-3 days and cleaning triangles.
Yes, and also there are some rules, for example, some NDA. I can't say a lot, like, because of NDA, but some brands, some car brands, it's not allowed to use CAD data, like, after the project. It's not possible to use this model even for your personal images. It's like they give you a model, but only for this exact project, and then you have to remove it and, like, delete from your computer and things not burn your computer.
Jesus.
So,
do you sign a lot of NDAs in Germany?
A lot, man, a lot. That's German, so they like papers.
Okay, man. So, what's your favorite though? Putting Turbo Squid on one side and heavy CAD data but perfect on the other side. What's like your favorite to work with, or is it just different?
I can work with everything, and as I said about exterior, usually it doesn't matter. You can use the both way. If we talk about interior, yes, definitely CAD is much more useful for this case because it has all the details. Depending on situation.
It feels like you're talking about everything. Now, you're talking about modeling. So, you're going to talk about everything. So, even if you're not modeling the car, you're still talking about modeling and how you can make different parts and engine and stuff?
No. Because, again, it can be a completely separated course about car modeling, and in our team we have like other guys, David and Max. They
just the basic tricks to
yeah. These guys, if you want to have some car modeling tutorial, these guys can teach a lot. But in our course, I showed, because we still have environment. It's not a photo. It's 3D and it's very simple, but it works very nice. And when I show in the block with modeling, I showed how to model this environment where we are. Like the detailed floor, buildings.
And it makes sense. Most of the time, you're not modeling cars. You're mostly modeling background stuff.
Yes, background stuff. Because yes. For example, in this particular situation, we didn't need to model the car, but we want to create some custom background. But it's very simple, but it's very difficult. You know, when you have some unique concrete environment in your mind, it's very difficult to find exact this environment on the stock because it's unique. It's your some crazy idea, and yeah, for sure in this case you need to model this. In this block I showed how to model this. And yes, the concept was made. Also, my partner Maxim, he has a very nice. He designed this this environment. He has a very, very powerful architectural skills, and he made a creative part for this environment.
Talking about designing the environment. Now I'm showing how you design the first. How can I call this? I don't know. Concepts, thumbnail sketch. How do you call it?
Yes. Here we were talking about the composition. And also here, as I said before, I showed how to create the small thumbnail sketches using just the mouse, with no any vacant tablet. Just, you know, because
just
it was a
with
set.
The mouse.
Yes, and you know. In this case, I need to create only the rough blocks, just the, you know, to just the main shapes. Like, okay, here, this will be a car, and find the like the positions for these main shapes. And because, you know, it's what I really like to work with shapes, because you can draw a shape and then start to think, okay, what it can be, because it can be, I don't know, part of the building, or part of, I don't know, it can be almost everything. And in this case, you can use your imagination for 100%, because you can build a rough composition and then start to think, okay, how it can work, what exactly it can be, and so on and so on.
That's pretty cool. So you made all the sketches on your Photoshop, and then
yep.
What happens when you take your sketches and put in the CG scene? Like, do you have to adapt stuff, or you can see stuff in 3D already and your concept's pretty much the final stuff?
No, it's just some basic points for me, just to see what exactly I want to have, some maybe angles. It's just because at this stage, when I start to draw some thumbnails, I have just the basic idea. And in this particular situation, it was okay, some after rain mood and a car, and I wanted to create a set. That was... That's it. So, and okay, when I found some you know, some composition options, so I started to improve it. And okay, and at least at this stage, like after thumbnails, I know that like what angles around I want to use. And in this case, I already can jump to 3ds Max and start to play with car and look how it works. Again, just using these rough concepts.
This is crazy. And, yeah, you're pretty much opening your workflow 100%, because you also have textures, applying textures,
yep.
Shaders. So you're going to
yep.
learn how to make the materials. Also,
yep.
Lighting, which is a completely different subject. HDR, caustics, render passes.
Yep.
Adjustment layers, workflow, everything.
It's yes.
Everything there. Dima, well,
yes.
You're not going to have anything else to teach.
That's just one part about car.
It's just the basics, right?
You know, no. It's like you can get from this tutorial, you can get the basic pipeline about cars, but I do not only cars. So, and
do you feel the knowledge you have from car visualization, you can take it to architectural stuff, you can take to your
yes,
other stuff,
yes,
even back shots?
Yes,
or
yeah, for sure, definitely.
It's all about lighting, composition. That makes it everything, right? Doesn't matter if it's a car or, I don't know, a water glass or a product. Or anything
yes.
else you want to sell, or even if it's not advertising, it could be whatever, movies, games. If you know about lighting, composition, shaders, what else? The basics of modeling. You don't have to be an amazing 100% modeler to do a lot of stuff. So, yeah. What about you, Dima? Do you work with ZBrush a lot?
Not little bit. I know how it works and I use it time by time with my projects, but usually I use ZBrush for adding some details to the model because it's just faster.
So mostly,
I don't know. For example,
hard
if
surface,
I...
right?
Yes, because for hard surface, you know, yeah, we don't need to use ZBrush for cars, you know, because we are not sculpting them. But for example, if I create, I don't know, I have one project that will come very soon, and there were some ZBrush parts. And also, for example, if I need to create, I don't know, some bed, you know, it it's definitely will be easy to improve some wrinkles or on the cloth using ZBrush, or I don't know if I need to create some chair. Yeah, also again adding some like texture filling and some wrinkles in ZBrush also is much faster and easier and easy. And yeah, for me it's just a tool. You know, I'm trying to play with different tools, like with ZBrush, 3D softwares, and Photoshop. And for me, it's also it's all the time the question about time and quality. And
showing your Behance page now, and it's crazy because there is so much stuff. It's not definitely a lot of cards because I know you love it. But
it was just the period of the last year, yeah. But I guess there will be lots of other things. What will come soon?
I see a lot of Brazilian work because I know you work a lot to Platinum. And what other Brazilian brands do you work with?
I guess Platinum, Light Farm, Zombie, Vetter Zero. Who else? I guess this is the
pretty much the main. all the main post production companies in the country. Crazy,
yep.
Man.
I guess yes.
This is really crazy, and I can see a little bit of your evolution from your work from years ago to the stuff you're doing now. It's really evolving, especially like the shaders, the lighting. It gets better over time. And yeah, judging like from the ones back in the day to the new ones, I don't know, they're all very good, man. It's and also like the beer stuff you do, crazy.
Yeah, you know it was some period because yeah, like last year it was like car year, but like I don't know, like 4 or 5 years ago there was like almost 1 year where when I was working with beer a lot. It was, I don't know, like I did, I don't know, 10, 20, 30 layouts with beer. And not only with beer, with different alcohol. I don't know, you know, some, I don't know what happened, but yeah, it was just some periods with different kind of projects. And yeah, I hope next year I already started to work with some animation because it's this is also because for me, you know, animation, it's not like one image. You need to create like few images and they come and become like an animation and as a video. So and I guess it will be like the next step for me, I hope.
Yeah, I'm just looking to some of your cars, the yellow one, the same that you're teaching at Aran High School.
Yep.
And I'm just imagining this running, animated. I think that will be the next step, right?
Yes, and I'm working on some animations right now, but yeah, there will be quite soon.
Do you think you animation is easy once you have I don't know,
yeah,
you have the shaders
yeah,
working,
definitely.
The light is working, yeah. And then what's next? I mean, you have to make the wheel spinning, and also the car physics is pretty particular, right?
Yeah. It's much easier, but right now. I think some animations what I create right now, they are not about cars. I don't know why. Because maybe I'm quite tired of creating cars, too much cars. But in general, yes, I like because I want to tell a story. And like even if you check some other projects there are, and even this project, it's not one image, it's more like a set, because always I'm trying to tell some even simple story but give some mood, you know, some feelings of environment. And
this,
I want to,
this is so cool, and because you get the same car with the same shaders, and then of course you have to adjust HDRs, but then I don't know, you work with with this car, and then you can make so many variations. You get a pack from a stock shot, a stock bank, you get a bunch of images. Then you can make all these different renders and have a campaign, right?
Yes, a campaign, and then try to imagine to create a video. And again, as you said, when you have skills of creating still images, it's much easier to jump to animation with this, because you know how it works, what exactly you need to get, and it will be just a question of software. But again, with software, it also, because for my animation, what I'm creating right now, I started to use DaVinci Resolve, and man, it's so cool.
It's so cool.
Yes, for color correction. And also, I didn't know that they bought Fusion and integrated inside. It looks like they bought lots of other companies and just put it inside. And that's so cool.
It's like Nuke, right? Fusion is like Nuke for composition.
They are competitors. They were competitors, but now when it's part of DaVinci, I think they are not competitors anymore. So, when you know what exactly you need to get, like how you blend and merge everything together for still images, it's easy to jump for the next step. This is why I was showing like pipeline like that.
Really cool, man. I think we're getting to the end point of this live, and I'm really excited, man, because I think this course will be really helpful for a lot of people, a lot of artists working with CGI, and I don't know, there's a lot of artists, they know how to do the CGI part, but they commit mistakes during the post-production, or the opposite, they know how to do the post-production, but they don't have the skills for CGI. So I think taking this course, I don't know, I think it's super helpful for many different artists. Even the lighting composition lessons would be really helpful for a lot of people, not only Photoshop and 3D artists.
Yes, I guess, because I guess the truth is somewhere between. People shouldn't be only 2D or 3D artists. It's just the tools. You know, you don't need to make a choice between brush and pencils. You know, you can use the both. Forgetting the best result.
That's true.
The same like that.
Man, do you mind if I finish this live in Portuguese and just say a few words?
Yes. Before, let me say valeu galera, and now keep going.
Okay. So, galera. Vou até dar um full screen aqui, só para explicar para vocês que o curso do Dima já está online. O curso de carro e Photoshop e 3D, luz, curso de composição. Nesse curso você vai aprender composição, thumbnail sketch, iluminação, textura. Você vai aprender os básicos de modelagem. Cara, é tanta coisa. Que até minha bateria acabou. Deixa eu aqui, calma aí. No finalzinho da live a minha bateria acaba, mas calma aí. Tá lá. I'm back. Ok. E é isso, galera. Tá já disponível agora. Se você acessar unhidespool.com, o Dima tá literalmente abrindo seu workflow completo, desde a parte do 3D V-Ray. 3ds Max até o Photoshop, onde ele ensina tudo, os passes, renderizar, shader, cáustica, cara, camada de ajuste, tudo. Esse cara tá realmente abrindo o workflow dele, e lembrando aí que o Dima é um artista conhecido no Brasil todo. O Dima trabalha para Vetor Zero, trabalha para Platino, trabalha com a Light Farm, trabalha com a Zombie. O cara... Eu acho que o Dima trabalha mais pro Brasil do que os brasileiros. É esse nosso russo que é mais brasileiro do que russo. É o Dima, nosso querido Dmitry Glazerin, que veio aqui lançar esse curso aqui com a gente. E eu só queria agradecer o Dima, cara, por estar fazendo isso, porque não é todo mundo que revela aí os seus segredos. E o Dima tá fazendo isso aqui na Unhide. Então, eu só queria agradecer o Dima e falar pra galera pra comer esse curso, porque é informação infinita aqui. Se você fizer esse curso do início ao fim, com certeza você vai dar um up no teu portifa infinito, ou dar um up nos trabalhos, dar um up no que você já tá fazendo no seu dia a dia, ou melhorar o seu workflow, se é que você já trabalha com carros, ou você quer trabalhar com produtos. Enfim, galera, essa é a hora. E vou dar um tchau pro Dima aqui. Dima?
Yep.
Tchau, tchau. Obrigado.
Valeu. Valeu. Hold on. Valeu, cara.
Valeu, cara.
Yes.
Valeu, Dima. Valeu, galera.
Valeu,
a gente se
Milton.
Fala em breve. See you later, man. Catch you later. See you soon. I see you around. You all is in Brazil, so.
Yeah, I'm going to reply some comments what we left.
Do it.
Okay.
Make sure you interact with the people at Unhide group as well, Unhide school group. It's okay. Growing really fast, and it's really cool because, I don't know, it's mostly in Portuguese, but you can post in English. There's a translation tool.
Okay.
Então é isso, galera. Valeu. Brigadão. Vocês ficaram aí até o final dessa live com o Dima, esse russo, gente fina pra caramba, que tá abrindo seu workflow de visualização de carros, que tá agora disponível na Unhide. Então é isso, galera. Valeu. Tá dado o recado.
Valeu.
Valeu. Valeu, Dima. Valeu, galera. Até
valeu,
breve.
Valeu.